Roxanne Torriello Show takes you inside Rikers Island. Inmates reveal lives of loneliness, regret, anger, fear. Then hear God's message of hope. And inmates, as they desire to turn from sin, to receive Jesus Christ for forgiveness and a new life. Inside Rikers Island.
The Roxanne Torriello Show takes you inside prison and jails as men reveal lives of sin and consequences. Hear God's amazing message of hope. Listen to the testimony of the infamous David Berkowitz and celebrities like Jerome Hines and Melba Moore, to athletes Marvis Frazier and Charles Way, to Dr. D. James Kennedy and Joe Douglas. The Roxanne Torriello Show, where you'll find out how to receive from God forgiveness, a brand new life, and eternal life.
Today, we're here in Rikers Island at the Anna M. Cross Facility, known also as C95. And I'm standing here with some of the inmates. Who's been here the longest? You have. How long have you been here?
About a year.
About a year. How many times have you been incarcerated?
About 7-8 times.
What's brought you back so many times?
Drugs.
Drugs brought you back. Out on the streets, how long do you usually last?
2 or 3 months.
What bothers you the most about prison life?
Having someone tell me what to do and not knowing when someone's going to cut me open or when I'm going to fight.
Worry about cut-ups and things like that? Death always hanging over your head?
Yes, it is.
How many times have you been here?
It's my first time here, but I've been in several other state institutions, yes.
For most of you guys, what's the scariest thing about being incarcerated, being in prison?
You gotta watch your back all the time.
Watch your back all the time? Fights, cut-ups, problems. In prison, is there friendship, laughter, kidding around?
You can laugh, but it's still, at the same time, you never know. They can laugh in your face and get stabbed in the back.
A lot of distrust here?
Right.
Amongst inmates?
Everybody around me is not either black, white, Spanish. It's all in all. We try to make a family here amongst us, but if not, still you got to do what you got to do to survive.
Prison, is it a place of anger, loneliness?
It's not real.
Bitterness? Do you come out the same person?
No.
How are you different?
Well, a lot of times people aren't different. They come right back. You know, they as soon as they get out, they forget what the experience was. It's like it was a dream. You know? They go right back to the same things they were doing in the streets, and they repeat the process all over again.
Now, a lot of people out in the world, outside the prison house, they say prison is a country club. They say you guys have TVs, you've got phones, you have gyms. Is prison a country club?
Better known as what I heard it, Belly of the Beast.
Is prison a country club?
No, it's no country club.
You have televisions, you have phones. They say you have televisions, phones.
If you have something, let's say you have a special program you want to see, you have rules and regulations you can see, you know, certain times, you know, like you can't turn it on when you want to, you can't turn it off when you want to, you know what I'm saying? It's a thing of like, you got orders, you got rules and regulations, you know, like the only thing I say about young people, if you don't want to take no orders, don't mess around and do nothing. You know what I'm saying? Because this is a whole totally different thing. You know what I'm saying?
Saying that there's a great loss of freedom here in prison?
Yes, it is. Very much.
Loss of freedom?
Yeah, very much.
How much?
When you go to court, like say, you have to strip naked.
Strip naked where?
You strip totally naked.
For what?
Your butt, you know what I'm saying?
For what? When do you strip naked?
Search for weapons, drugs, smuggling, things like that. You know, that hurts me a lot. Deep inside, you know, because I'm a man. I don't have to show my ass to nobody.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? That hurts me very much. Because, you know, you have to go through what they say.
You actually stand there, even during a visit. Am I right? You have a visit, you have to strip naked?
Yeah.
So there's a problem. People come to prison because they're not obeying
the laws outside of prison. Okay. Yet when you come into prison, you find that there are many more laws and rules and regulations.
There's a lot of guys out on the street that they think they're tough guys.
Tough guys.
But when they come here, mm-hmm. they find themselves in the cells. All that toughness goes away. They start crying. The biggest
not
thing,
tough anymore.
They're not tough anymore. You see them crying. When they see they got 10, 15 years up ahead of them, they're not going to see the daylights. You know what I'm saying?
A lot of bitterness, anger, rage. Anyone very bitter here or angry?
They're all angry, you know. And a lot of hostility shows, you know, comes out, you know, when tensions rise, you know, people snap. And they release the hostilities, you know, and that's one of the main dangers here, you know. People take out their frustrations on each other.
How lonely is prison?
Very, very lonely.
Is it a lonely place here?
Yes.
I mean, I see with the whole group of guys here.
No,
you look like you're all friends and not the case?
There's no such thing as friends here.
No friends here? I mean, I see you with all of these guys here.
Acquaintances.
You know what I'm saying?
There's no true friendship here in prison?
Why
is that? Why?
Nah,
can't trust one another?
Cannot trust one another.
Why? What's the fright? What's the scare that you can't trust one another?
Today
and going tomorrow. You mean new men constantly coming in. You don't know who they are, what they've done out in the streets.
You got a lot of people that rape people. You don't know what they have done in the streets. You got people that sell drugs. You know what I'm saying? I think that somebody that sells drugs is not a violent person. You know, because all you do is trying to make some money. But then you have people that are murderers. You know what I'm saying? They put you together with them and they don't want to take. You know, you're talking to them right now, but they get a little angry and they come and stab you, cut you in the face.
Common? Always thinking about those kind of things, always watching your back. So I see a group of men here, and really, are you really trying to say that you really don't maybe trust each other?
I want to be here one more minute. I wouldn't say that. You know, it's like in society. Anywhere you go, you know, you have to have someone, a special one, that you can put at least 85% trust in. Mm-hmm. Because you cannot watch your back. You know what I'm saying? Totally. It's not such thing as friends, because you meet people that you can become real close to, you know. When you leave, you want them to go with you, you know what I'm saying? Rather than to be in here. It's not safe, totally not trust, you know, but you don't put 100% trust in nobody. You only trust one person, that's you.
What's the worst time of the day or night for you?
Anybody wakes up with an attitude.
You say they wake up with an attitude. What do you mean by that?
Breakfast at 4 o'clock in the morning. And
excuse me. You're eating breakfast at 4 o'clock in the morning.
So everyone wakes up with an attitude, you know. If one person cuts the other person in line, the other one looks at him and that starts off triggering a little attitude. We were getting 5 sugars. Now we get 4 sugars. They get attitudes over 4 sugars. Somehow, so you go through, you get 3. And I mean,
everything is kind of rationed.
Right. But when someone gets a little more than the next one, another one gets an attitude.
I mean, there could be a breakout, a fight over how many, over a package of, over one pack of sugar. Package of sugar could cause, half a pack of sugar could cause what? Here, a fight. I mean, the smallest little thing can arouse problems.
A cigarette. One cigarette can cause a fight. I mean, this here, this is the easiest place to get in. Hard to get out. Hard. To be here years and some people years and years trying to get out.